Oriental bittersweet is a clever vine. In search of sunshine, it encircles a host tree trunk and quickly winds its way to the top. Aggressive, Oriental bittersweet attacks the trees like a boa constrictor and squeezes the life out of the tree while also smothering the forest below. In this video, we're going to first show you how to identify Oriental bittersweet and then show you how to get rid of it. Identifying Oriental bittersweet can be tricky because there's another vine that looks very similar to it called American bittersweet, which is a native plant and not a problem. Because American and Oriental bittersweet look so much alike, let's take a moment to compare the two. Both bittersweets have similar leaves, so it's best not to rely on leaves for identification. Instead, we look at the flowers and berries. With Oriental bittersweet, female plants have flowers and berries all along the stem, while American bittersweet is relaxed and droopy, with flowers and berries only at the ends. Another clue is the color of the seed capsules. Oriental bittersweet has yellow seed capsules, while American has orange. A good way to remember is, give a yell if you see yellow. Orange is okay. The berries of both species are easiest to see in the autumn, after the leaves have fallen. Berries of many varieties are a favorite food for birds. They take flight and spread seeds across the landscape as they go. This is the main way Oriental bittersweet spreads. People are also attracted to the berries and help spread the seeds without knowing it. When they sprout, seedlings start out small and innocent looking, but over time, they grow into large, climbing troublemakers. Now let's talk about how to wage war on this menace. To prepare for battle, know your enemy. You must be properly protected to safely manage this menace. Err on the side of caution and wear safety glasses, a hard hat, long clothes, gloves, and boots. The tools you'll need to battle this beast include hand pruners, bypass loppers, hand saw, and possibly, for a truly aggressive infestation, a chainsaw. Herbicide is an important tool in fighting this battle, but you have to be careful when using herbicide to protect yourself and native vegetation. You'll need your protective gear plus a spray bottle or a backpack sprayer. Be sure to check the label for specific directions. Though control of Oriental bittersweet can happen at any time of year, it is easiest in the autumn after the leaves have fallen. The growth is divided into three parts: large vines, small vines, and seedlings. When fighting Oriental bittersweet, we first start with large berry-producing vines. These mother plants can be killed using a chainsaw to cut a 6-inch section out 1 to 3 feet above the ground. Then, in order to kill the vine, you must treat the stump end of the vine with herbicide immediately for maximum control. There is no need to apply herbicide to the vine end because it will die anyway. In your effort to rid the world of this aggressive forest monster, you may be tempted to rescue the tree by pulling out the vine. Beware! This can lead to serious injury and death. These vines are heavy, and the potential energy of both vine and tree is significant. Do not pull the vines. After treating large vines, we tackle the small ones. Small vines can be annihilated with hand tools and herbicide. Small vines might look innocent, but they are merely waiting for their turn to devastate the forest. It might be tempting to bombard the site with herbicide, but you need to take a moment. Carefully calibrate your equipment, assess the area so you don't accidentally harm the good plants. In getting rid of this harmful vine, it may not be immediately clear if you've won the battle or not. Here is an example of a site that has had Oriental bittersweet treated. A year after treatment, please revisit the battleground to see if your victory is complete. It is critical to continue monitoring your site. On behalf of our forests, we thank you.